shouldn't eat that many mangoes, but I will.
I'll kind of turn into a bag of dried mangoes.
I will one day be a bag of dried mango. But yeah.
Yeah, that's not, if you've been watching the channel for a while, that's honestly not even that surprising.
It's really not.
Wow. God, it's now 100% cooler in here because of that fan.
Yeah, it is. I need like a weird sweater cape blanket.
That's oddly specific, but okay.
It's because that's what the blanket is. It's a sweater cape.
So, I feel like...
Cardigan.
I feel like by this point, scarf. It's fairly obvious that I'm going down the Scott route, so...
Yeah.
I'm going to go down the Scott route. Vera's drinking her customary lunchtime scotch because you can drink whatever the hell you want at this school, but Scott's not making it easy for her. Bro. Hey, Vera, what you drinking?
Scotch. Why?
Because it smells like a delicious forest fire, and I'm curious, what's it called?
Scotch.
Yes?
No, that's what it's called.
What?
Scotch.
Yes?
No, I'm not saying your name. I'm saying the name of the drink I'm drinking. It's scotch.
It's mine?
No, it's mine.
Then why is it called Scott's?
That's just what it's called.
Oh, it's like an energy drink for Scots.
I mean, it's like an energy drink for Scottish people.
Hey, I'm a Scottish person. I'm as Scottish as possible to be. I'm the most Scott.
No, gah, what will it take to get you to drop this issue?
Scott's not going to drop it unless you do something. So you cut in and say, yeah, it's called Scott's, but today is opposite day, so everything that's Scott's is actually Vera's. Or you're right, Scott, that drink is your birthright.
Chug, 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 chug.
You don't have to tell me 5 times. Bottoms up.
No, what are you doing? Stop.
Okay, I just drank the whole bottle anyway.
You utter twit. That scotch was brewed for King Tutankhamun himself. I had to have an adventuring archaeologist betrayed and murdered for that bottle.
What? Sorry? Could you say that again? Blackout drunk from all your scotch I drank.
You're impossible.
I'm impossible! Hooray!
Oh, he's so funny!
He drags Scott away to escape Vera's wrath. He spends the afternoon doing all your math homework for you. Turns out Scott's way smarter when he's blacked out.
Ah, interesting.
Well, I think I'm already here anyway.
Yeah, you're kind of locked in with Ghost Lady there.
The Ghost Lady or the Mermaid Lady, both of which are pretty cool.
Aw, man. I guess I'm going to have to date the demon guy. I didn't want to.
You could find someone else. There's still time, maybe.
All right. I'm trying to comprehend your request.
What is there to comprehend? It's really simple, Miranda. Take my cell phone, snap a pic of me face, planting in my food with my eyes closed and tongue out.
But okay. Wherefore?
Okay, wait, what? Okay, I know I read that wrong.
No, like, it was okay. Fine. It was okay. The cadence was what was wrong. You didn't actually get any of the words wrong.
The wrong emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Yes, your emphasis was bad. Yuck.
Right here, Miranda.
You're about to point out that wherefore means why, but luckily Polly elaborates on her own, so you don't have to look like a fucking know-it-all.
It's a new meme, Miranda, like planking or dabbing. It's called food poisoning, and it's dope as fuck. Don't you have cool trends in your kingdom?
I suppose we do. Oh, we have a fun trend called revere your rulers. It's where you show nothing but the utmost devotion for the royal family. If you're good at it, you get lots of likes on social media and also not executed.
Wow. Do you ever listen to yourself when you speak? I bet you know some pretty cool trends, don't you, Fee?
Heck yeah, you do, don't you? Surely do. It's entitled Silverware Wear, and it's where you take your most expensive cutlery and dress it in tiny fancy outfits.
Yup, it's called dying.
Oh, it's totally called dying. Yup.
Yes! Dying is my fucking fave! I mean, listen, the first time I did it, I was like, okay, now I don't get to be alive anymore. But when all the cool ghost stuff kicked in, I was like, oh my god, dying is awesome! Everyone should die!
I'm not sure if I would be into this dying trend, but I do know that Daddy's Reign helps many peasants achieve this meme, so it's nice to know that they're becoming super popular on social media in the process.
Remind me not to ever hang out in Miranda's kingdom on break. But hey, Fee, maybe you and I can hang out and do some dying together.
Ooh.
Yay, maybe. Yeah, yay.
Let's do this!
Yay!
Hell yeah, let's do it!
I like how our characters do have their own character voices.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Okay, so I could go with these fools. Or I could find out who this mysterious person is.
I think I know who the mysterious person is.
Ooh, do you?
Yes.
Do you want to tell me about it?
No.
Fuck! Tony, why won't you ever be a pal and help me out?
Show the viewers!
Well, he's got like an elfish looking ear.
Yeah.
God. Check it out. God. Legally distinct, Mal!
What?
We need to be legally distinct.
I said his ears look like elf ears. What is wrong with that?
We'll have the Tolkien estate after us.
I can't say the word elf.
Elf. A-E-L-F.
Fiona,
elf.
Not you too.
Elf.
No, we'll have the fox. We'll fox pictures after us.
You barely sat down when the whole wolf pack comes running over, clearly panicking.
Dog, you gotta help us. We're suffocating. It's like we're not getting enough air. We can hardly talk.
Ah, you see the problem. You remind them that in addition to breathing out, they need to also breathe in.
No way. Oh, whoa, that works totally better. I have no idea. We forgot about that.
Yeah, you don't either.
Thanks for saving our lives, dog. We owe you one, and we'll pay you back. Right now, what do you want? We literally do anything.
Teach me calculus or give me an extreme makeover.
Oh, shit. I don't think you need an extreme makeover.
I don't because I am very attractive already. Teach me calculus.
Well, we don't know what calculus is, which means we're the perfect dogs to teach it to you. We've never gotten a calculus question wrong.
I like how the dog spirits are like, they're playing out. Football.
Well, it's the football team, yeah. Mm-hmm. If it's anything like the other math, all we gotta do is stick the textbook in a blender.
Yep, they totally brought a blender with them.
Add some protein powder and hemp milk, blend it up. And pour it in your ear canal. That's right, next to the brain, so it'll get there fast.
This is the stupidest thing you've ever heard. Possibly the last thing, too, if this pureed book destroys your hearing. But within seconds, you feel numbers trickling through your synapses. It actually worked? No wonder these idiots haven't been kicked out of school yet. They've got a foolproof study method. You gave 4 smarts. Hell yeah.
That's good. You were pretty low on the smarts department.
Yeah.
How shitty it would be for your country if you were president.
I mean, it would be better for... Do you want to random this one?
We all know that. Wait, why would we random this one?
Okay. So first is Mal. Well, wait. Well, who would be the most shitty at being president?
I think this is funny because like, you're supposed to argue who would be like your... No, I would be the shittiest, and here's why I would be the shittiest. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so who would be the shittiest? Do you think... Who in this room thinks they would be the shittiest?
I would... Yeah, I have a plan for this already, so I would probably be least shitty at it.
Least shitty. Okay, cool. Tony?
I have a plan.
I'm back to your random idea.
Okay, random.
Not gonna lie.
Random.
Yep.
Who'd be least shitty?
Hell yeah, most shitty. I was gonna say that.
I'd be medium shitty.
Wow, truly we've...
Last day before prom.
Oh, right, because there's probably a whole thing at the end there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right. Fuck.
Oh, and the Eidolon is nowhere to be seen.
Nope.
Right, oh, boy.
You get some money. You're going to go to the gym.
In the gym?
Play dodgeball? I don't know. You should do it.
It might be...
You're bold.
It might be charm, actually. I'm not sure.
I could use some more of that.
I don't know, but, you know, let's...
Do it.
Yeah, you know, we'll see.
I ain't going to class. That day an epic dodgeball match takes place. Look at how fucking cool I am. But the match isn't as important as the human interactions within it.
Oh, man.
You're at your peak when you decide to go for the overkill and wink at one of your teammates.
Shit.
He's totally mesmerized. It's the most epic wink ever. Damn, you know how to win over other people's hearts. You gain +2 charm. Oh. Hell yeah.
That's just a skeleton in the background.
I know. Yeah. You join Miranda and Damien's team for game 2. It goes differently.
Come on, shit dicks. Face the power of hell.
Paint this battlefield red, Damien. Grind them all into a thin red paste.
You express your worry and confusion over the number of corpses in the gym. Isn't this supposed to be a friendly game?
Friendly? What the fuck is friendly? I only have 2 words in my vocabulary. Kill and murder.
Honor, glory, feudalism. These are the words we will fight for. These are the words we will die for.
Whoa, you didn't sign up to die. You gotta stop this before it turns into an FPS or something. Get off my nuts, narrator. You don't understand the ancient reasons for dodgeball slaughter. Many died before us, but we won't waver. Guys, it's just a dodgeball. Let's throw the ball and have fun.
I feel like one of these is so much more obvious than the other.
Fine, be that way. So bold.
Bring it on.
You cock your shotgun. Why do you have a shotgun? And stand beside Damien. Double kill. Triple kill. Quad damage. The gym is ruined. Blood is everywhere. Half of your classmates are maimed. Are you happy? Here, have +3 money as loot or something. It's a dating game and you killed a bunch of people. How should I know what to give you?
Oh, God.
Wow.
Oh, I'm into it.
Jesus Christ, Mal.
I'm gonna do
Wow,
auditorium.
Damn. I always knew you had it in you.
That day, while rehearsing for the class play, you totally forget your lines. It's terrible. But you don't let that get you down. You start improvising all of your lines. And it's marvelous. Somehow it enhances the path of the play in unexpected ways. And that's saying something, since half of your improvisation is a rap battle against your inner fears.
Oh,
wow.
Nice.
Wow, is this like Hamilton 2? Yeah, you gain +2 creativity.
Fuck, you're the most creative.
I'm super creative. Forget about that, though. Polly's here, and she looks ready to party. So basically, just normal.
There you are, my favorite party favor besides ecstasy. You game you ready to get crazy?
That is a line. I am telling you, that is a good line.
Yeah, that's very good.
You indicate through a heart-stopping glow stick maneuver that you are indeed ready to hit the clubs.
The clubs? Not tonight, boo. Tonight, we're going to engage in my favoritest pastime.
Dying!
Party crashing! I just love crashing parties and making them go wilder and crazier, you know? Tonight, we're going to crash this totally sweet baby shower I just heard about.
Aw, yeah.
And knowing you, I bet you've got some killer ideas for how we should crash it.
Nothing amps up a baby shower like extra babies! Literally crash into the party, like with a boat. No, extra babies sounds hilarious.
Extra babies sounds hilarious.
Yes! Finally something to do with all those babies I won in that raffle!
Later that night...
Who ordered a dump truck full of babies?
The party guests cannot answer. They are literally drowning in babies.
Now this is a party! I don't know why they even call it a baby shower if there isn't a constant shower of babies.
Oh my god.
Oh, these babies are so cute! I bet I could fit a whole one in my mouth. You're welcome, guys!
The drowning party guests actually do look pretty happy to be drowning in babies. A week later, you each get a thank you note for reminding us what a baby shower is all about. Swimming in a pool of babies. You gain +2 fun and +1 charm.
Your stats are getting really good, Fee.
Well, I don't have any money, but I'm more fun than I was.
Yeah.
I mean, not as good as Tony's over there.
I mean, I am good at games.
You are super smart and bold and creative.
Yeah, you know, you can just kind of keep talking.
And charming.
Oh,
and fun and money, I guess.
I am money.
Wow.
Okay. Well, we know what outdoors gets you. We know what the bathrooms get you.
Yep.
Oh, man.
Boldness.
Another bathroom.
That day, you skip class and just hang out in the bathrooms because we still don't respect no authority. On the way there, you run into Mamimi, the Oni girl. She offers you some of her weird Japanese energy drink. You take a sip. It tastes crazy as hell. You need to check the contents of this shit. Guarana seed extract, benzoic acid, 50 milligrams of caffeine, and 100 milligrams of baldness.
Where? What's the name of this energy drink so I can buy it in my Yakuza?
Hell yeah.
You gain +2 bonus. Thanks, Mamimi, and proceed to the bathrooms. Sick. After that, it's time for the most important part of school, visiting Scott's Kingdom of Furry Animals, as
shit.
Promised.
Wow.
When you get to the forest, you find that most of the trees have been decorated with beautiful, intricately drawn pictures of an even more muscular-than-life Scott having various kinds of sex with various different giant furry animals. Tony, my royal advisor, here to royally advise me while I sit on my Scott throne and rule over my Scott friends. Aren't these sweet little furry forest creatures devoted to me? It makes my tail wag with joy. Is at that point that one of the sweet little furry forest creatures' giant heads falls off, revealing a very startled-looking mummy. Yep, Vera called it. Bunch of kiki furry people doing furry stuff in the woods. Oh no! What? What just happened? Is he hurt? Is my little panda friend hurt? Or was my panda friend never a panda friend at all? Oh, no. Scott will not be losing his pure joy and innocence over some furry's shitty costuming skills. Not on your watch. Not today. You think quickly. You know how deer shed their antlers, then they grow back? Talking furry forest creatures shed their heads. Or, Scott, that panda must have been a cursed prince, and now you've turned him back into a person.
Absolutely the first one.
Oh, God, I really like both of them, honestly.
What you gonna do, Tony?
One of these is a more correct answer than the other one.
What you gonna do?
I don't know. I feel like so many of these use your creativity stat.
Do it. Do that one.
It's up to you.
You're charming.
It is up to me. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to go with this. Scott, you turned it back into a person.
So charming.
I've heard about those kinds of curses before. And I broke the spell with my love for my furry friends. As their king, of course, I don't love them in the way they draw me loving them. Ah! They're very interesting pictures, though. Thanks for helping me out, Tony. I guess I love you, too, in a way.
Wink.
And you guess you love him, too. And you love getting plus two fun and plus one smart.
Damn, Tony's souped up.
Right?
The monster prom draws near. Who will I ask to prom? Damien, Polly, Scott, Vera, Miranda, or Liam?
Who are you going to ask, Mal?
Wait,
can you ask yourself?
Yes.
None of them.
You can be your own bold self and go.
Oh, boy.
Just for that jacket?
Yeah.
I would buy that jacket.
Yeah, same.
3 seconds.
Same. I feel like I'm pretty inspired to ask none of them.
All right.
Do it.
Showtime.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Polly's grown on me. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, she's
Polly's pretty
wasted
fun.
All the time.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like at one point you could have gone towards Miranda. I think it's Miranda, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I ended with Polly. I'm down for Polly.
Yeah, Polly.
Let's see what Polly looks.
Yes.
Oh, I'm my little friend.
Yeah, your little friend.
I wish the little friend had a bow tie right now.
Yeah.
All right. And I'm very clearly going down the Scott train. Uh-huh. Let's ask Scott out.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Beautiful.
I like my little sweater and collar.
You asked no one to prom. You told yourself you didn't need anyone. And you know, on a theoretical level, that's completely true. But this just seems like a way of avoiding potential rejection.
Oh.
We all feel rejection, sweetheart. But it's a part of life. Victory is for those who try. And you haven't.
Oh my god.
Prom night is here, and you can't help but wonder if you had a chance with any of your classmates. Those who fail have at least tried. And you? Tonight you failed in your own way, without even trying. Just some kind of twisted merit in its own right. Doubts will haunt you till the day you die. Prom was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and now it's gone. Oh, no, wait, this is a video game. You can try and play again. Lucky bastard.
Oh,
so
nothing happened to me.
You finally pluck up your courage and ask your beloved to go to the monster prom with you.
What? Not a chance in the world, darling.
What?
Poor life choices is how I died. So how can I teleport afterlife choice? So now I can teleport afterlife choice when I see one. And boo, you're a big one.
No way.
You couldn't get a date for Monster Prom. Actually, you couldn't get a date for the rest of your life.
No.
Some nights alone in your bed, you wish sadness was an STD. Oh, sorry.
That's fine.
Oh, sorry. That'd be so brutal if that was Polly saying that.
Yeah. Some nights alone in your bed, you wish sadness was an STD because then at least you wouldn't be getting so much of it.
Let's go. Oh, boy. Wow. All right, Tony.
I struck out bad.
Prom? I'm not sure, bro. I have a kingdom to rule, and attending prom doesn't seem very responsible as a ruler. I don't know about history. Maybe some other king or queen has stopped visiting their kingdom to attend prom? I should check. I mean, I think you're the one person I trust the most. I'd love going to prom with you, but my kingdom. Sometimes a good teammate has to make sacrifices for the team. You know, the teammate is me, and the team is my kingdom. Oh, and the sacrifice is not going with you to prom. I truly am sorry. Sometimes there's not enough space in one Scott for both ruling a kingdom and love. Bye.
No!
Wow. Scott leaves you and you swear you saw a manly tear running down his cheek. It's okay. You started all this to seduce Scott, but now you put more value on his happiness, on his pursuit of a career as king of a totally fake kingdom. You stay by his side as the best furry concierge that...
Consigliere
that has never existed. Your relationship with Scott strengthens, and in the end, his kingdom sees that. Scott thought his kingdom and love weren't compatible, yet it seems to be quite the opposite. Scott's subjects started drawing lots of suggestive art pieces depicting the two of you.
Oh.
Facing that explicit art made you rethink the nature of your relationship, and it ended up being closer to all that not safe for work art.
So, fuck!
Tony is best at actually learning something at school.
Oh, boy.
Holy shit,
Holy
okay.
crap, so we got one ending.
Uh-huh.
28 out of 384.
Oh, shit. Christ. Okay, we have to play this game again.
I will definitely be playing some more of this game.
We'll see if we play it again.
We maybe will. I'm not sure.
We need Chaz.
Yes. We need Chaz.
All right. Well, if
we need more Agents of Chaos in this game.
If you see more of this game, that's how you'll know that we've played more of this game.
Wow.
But otherwise, that's Monster Prom.
No, yeah. Look at Scott.
Oh,
those 3 weeks were maybe the most epic and absurd weeks of our lives. After Monster Prom, we kept on living our lives, falling in love, battling for friendship, and learning who we were and who we could be. And you know what? As it always does, life happened. And it was wonderful. To this day, it seems Miranda still isn't sure about what exactly porn is.
We're getting epilogues.
Liam and Scott co-wrote a cheesy and weird fanfic of two lights that became unexpectedly popular, to the point it turned into a well-known novel of its own.
Oh. Wow.
Half of the characters are shirtless, for all the right reasons. Polly took a summer job as the ghost of Christmas present. She spent most of the time partying, since there was almost no work because, you know, it was summer. During those 3 weeks, Monster Prom seemed bigger than life, and then it was gone, just like that. The battle for Monster Prom might have ended then, but there were lots of battles left in that war called youth. But once again, we were young and unafraid, and we were ready to start.
Oh.
This is really cute. Look at you, Shadow Person.
I wonder if this is hinting at.
Oh, parents. Look at you guys in the background.
It sure seems to be hinting.
Oh, God. Oh, yeah. I'm playing pool and I'm very cool.
Oh, it's the ultimate fantasy.
Oh, this game is really good. I like it a lot.
Yeah. Oh, this video is going to get hit for copyright.
Oh, yeah, maybe so.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, look at my hair. Very good.
So, yeah, not going to lie. Good ass game. This is a fantastic follow-up to the Yogg.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Like, yeah. This is the logical next step of the Yogg.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really excited to see what these developers do next.
Yeah.
Because this game's been out for a month or two, mm-hmm. I think. Something like that. Maybe.
Dodgeball!
Hell yeah.
But there's a lot of actual literal murder in Monster High.
There sure is.
Never mind.
Yes? Are you sure?
Not gonna worry about the fact that they wanted to make it prom themed, but whatever.
I mean, they made everybody old.
God, this is really fun music, though.
It is.
All right.
They had a credit for the song.
They did have a credit for the song.
Slightly earlier, you can just rewind.
Those awesome guys. Game by Beautiful Glitch.
Beautiful Glitch.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was Monster Prom. So, hey, everybody, if you enjoyed the video, hit the subscribe button.
Aww.
We also have a Patreon you can check out in the end card or in the video description.
We've just unlocked an erotic fanfic about dragons. This is about to get weird.
All right, we'll see you later when it gets weird. Bye,
everybody. Bye.